everyone. The wife of the late Paul Gray took the stand in the manslaughter trial against a Des Moines pain doctor.
Gray was one of the founding members of the rock group Slipknot, and Mark Tauschek was in the courtroom today as she testified. Mark?
Brenna Gray gave heart-wrenching testimony about her efforts to document her late husband's rampant drug use in an attempt to save him. She says he was given prescriptions for Xanax by Dr. Daniel Baldi as he struggled to overcome an addiction to the anti-anxiety drug. But Baldi's defense portrayed a much different scenario. Slipknot is a unique band known worldwide. One of the founding members was Paul Gray, who was found dead of a drug overdose in this Urbandale hotel in 2010. This afternoon, on day 7 of the manslaughter trial of Dr. Daniel Baldi, the wife of the most famous of the 9 alleged victims took the stand to testify for the state against the doctor she says recklessly contributed to her husband's death in part by overprescribing Xanax.
I just knew it was a drug of his choice that he had struggled with in the past. So I just wasn't very sure why he was on it. Prescribed it.
Brenna Gray says she attended her husband's appointments with Dr. Baldi and shared her concerns, finding pill bottles that were empty, seeing her husband passed out inside their home. The official cause of death was an overdose of fentanyl and morphine, neither of which were prescribed by Dr. Baldi.
If Paul got the morphine or the fentanyl on the street somewhere, that it's nobody's fault except Mr. Gray. Or the person you got it from?
That's a hypothetical question. I don't know why I have to answer hypothetical questions. I don't know where he got them from.
Brenna Gray's 90 minutes of testimony ended with a comment that might stick with the jury.
I answered it's nobody's fault but Mr. Gray's in my deposition. That's correct.
Thank you, ma'am. No further questions.
This morning, both sides also presented their arguments to the judge today concerning the latest motion by the defense to dismiss this case. The defense says a prosecution witness, a pain treatment specialist from up in the Twin Cities, was not disclosed in a timely manner. The judge said this morning that he'll rule on that motion later this week.
Mark, thank you.